Now I think about it, I should have played something a little bit more European Championsy. You know, what with the Euro 2016 going on in France at the moment? But heck, I didn't have a lot of money as a kid, and so I had to play budget football games. And thus we're on to this one. European club soccer has had a number of different names. In Europe it is called FUS, however in North America it is called World Trophy Soccer, and in Japan it is called J-League Champion Soccer. Strangely, the game was originally based on yet another name for various computers called Manchester United Europe. It was made by Krisalis Software, and hopefully it's pronounced right, and published by Virgin Games in 1992. In case you haven't guessed, this is a 1-2 player football game where you're able to play as a bunch of club teams across Europe in either a club competition or friendly match. There are no official player names, and there are around about 117 different teams to select, with the strangest appearance being Rotherham United, who, as if you're a football fan, you'll know that they've never been that good. I don't think they've ever been in the top division. They're apparently in this game due to developers being based in Rotherham rather than any of their footballing prowess. The game is played from a side-on view and everything looks fairly solid for a Mega Drive title with some good animation and well-drawn sprites. It's just a shame that this crowd is a static image and it seems like there are two sets of 10 clones on the pitch with every single player looking the same as the next. It makes you wonder why they bothered to fake the players' names appearing at the bottom of the screen, as there's no real reason to favour one footballer over the next. They play and act exactly the same. It's also sloppy that there's no animation for when you score a goal, which is one of the major moments in a 90-minute game. Even bad soccer games have a static image when you score. The biggest problem with this title is the gameplay. The A button allows you to switch between players to control, the B button passes or tackles, and the C button does a lob as well as shoot. I'm not 100% sure how to shoot. I've done it before, but I'm not sure how. The majority of the time pressing C simply does this really slow lob, which is really, really useless, as you're pretty much giving back possession to your opposition. So naturally, a football game where you struggle to work out how to shoot is quite a frustrating experience. Now, I have done it numerous times before as a kid. I mean, I do remember that there was actually a bug with the goalkeepers where you can actually score straight from the kickoff, straight from the center square. And I used to exploit that a lot as a kid. But I can't seem to work it out anymore. But maybe it's just something with me. It also doesn't help that the tackling and the collision detection is off. You were regularly make a tackle and completely miss. I even tried purposely fouling my opponent, and majority of the time I just kept on missing. And I mean, generally when you go for the legs, that usually means you're going to commit a foul, but you know, the other player just kept on going on. As one of the first football games that I actually played on the Sega Mega Drive, I felt this was fairly enjoyable back in the day. However, it's clearly not aged very well, particularly since after I've played FIFA International Soccer and the ISS game by Konami on the system, which are much better in terms of gameplay, presentation, virtually everything. But nevertheless, let's get on with this and let's get on with playing the game.